Hello friends, another long term prediction coming true today. I told you that gold will achieve 1680 levels, and this was the time when gold was trading at around 1800-1900 levels. I had told you that gold will hit 1680 as the first target and 1600. In fact, it has lot much to achieve below 1600 also, but yes, it may take some time. Also, we have already seen silver achieving 1800. That was another prediction I had given few months back. Similarly, on Dow Jones, Nasdaq, multiple indices and multiple commodities, few months back I have predicted for all coming true. Now, what is going to happen? Let's have a look today for gold, Nasdaq 100, Dow Jones. We will see with the help of candlestick charts and indicators. Do not forget to like, share, subscribe and comment. Do not forget to press the bell icon. Let's start the day with gold first. And yes, first will be gold, followed with Nasdaq 100, and in the end we'll see Dow Jones. Do watch till the end, do listen to it carefully, do press the bell icon. The next analysis will be up before the Asia session. So this is the second analysis for these instruments for the day. Now look at the hourly charts, trading at the bottom of the Bollinger Bands. Also look at this, the Bollinger Band getting curved here, and it is almost giving it a support, and hence 1680 levels now the stronger support for gold. Probably with that as support, it may try to reverse. One can take a long entry at around 1686 level, but then 1690 is the ultimate resistance for the day. It may get the resistance at around 1688, 89, rather 90 levels, and probably it may trade between 1680 to 1690 levels itself. This appears on the hourly chart, bearish, stochastic bearish, looking upwards. MACD trying to converge, RSI oversold on the 2-hour chart. Similarly, it is trading at the bottom of the Bollinger Bands, trying to get the support. The next resistance zone definitely is at 1700. It may try to achieve these levels, but yes, be cautious of 1692-93 levels. Yes, first resistance at 1690 will be there, then 1692-93, and then beyond that 1700 levels will come into picture. So be watchful of 1693-95. It may achieve that before looking forward to a drop. Directional movement is bearish, stochastic is oversold and it is also bearish. This is MACD, which is oversold, and this is bearish, and it is trying to converge. Yes, stochastic is already, we have seen, this is oversold. The RSI is oversold too, trying to bounce back. Similarly, on the 3-hour charts, yes, it is also trading at the bottom of the Bollinger Bands, trying to bounce back. Resistance at 1700 and 1702 is there. Yes, it can reverse strongly on the upside. Be cautious, be watchful. Directional movement is bearish. Stochastic is oversold, MACD is oversold, and it is wide divergent and bearish. RSI looking upwards on the 3-hour charts. Similarly, on the 4-hour charts, it is trading outside the Bollinger Bands, trying to bounce back. The next resistance zone is at 1691-92 levels. Beyond that, 1695, and then it may try to hit 1700, which is the ultimate resistance zone. Also look at this, 1680 is the next support level on the downside. If it breaks 1680, yes, you can go long. Directional movement bearish, stochastic oversold, MACD is wide divergent and it is still on the sell side. RSI is oversold too on the 4-hour charts. And now look at the daily charts. I told you today earlier in the day that, see, it is giving you lower highs, and after this consolidation, this is the first breakout candle. We may see a second breakout candle, and I told you that it may be of same size of this candle, and this is where precisely it has achieved 1680 levels. Now it is trying to consolidate in between 1680-1695. In between, above this, yes, you can expect it to rise till towards 1700, which is the next resistance zone, and beyond that we may see it flying high for 1710. Beyond that you can consider that as reversal. I don't expect it to happen today, hence it may trade range bound. Directional movement bearish, stochastic at bottom, MACD is on sell side trying to converge, and RSI is oversold. Considering this, I will not recommend you to take a trade between 1680 and 1695. $15, very large range. If you still want to take a trade, yes, you can remain long with the stop loss at 1680, but be cautious as it has still got some little room for it to drop till towards 1676 and 1674 levels. So yes, be watchful of this. It has got a little room for it to drop below these levels, but I expect that it may largely remain range bound, and hence with the stop loss at 1680. One can expect a rise, and one can expect it to again achieve 1687 and then 1691-92 zone, and then 1695 is the next target. Beyond 1695, it is definitely going to go bullish. I don't expect that to happen. Even if it rises, it is again going to come back till towards 1695. So take your trades accordingly. Trade with caution. 1680 is the level you should watch out for. 1695 on the upside is the level you should watch out for. In between these 15 points, still with the support, because right now it is at 1684, you can still go long, keeping at stake $4. But be cautious. Now let's have a look at Nasdaq 100. Look at Nasdaq 100. See, it is consolidated here. It is consolidated here. Now since multiple hourly candles, it is just consolidating in between this zone. It is failing to break past the lows and it is failing to break past the highs out there. Yes, there is a support at 12,400 now and then 12,380. Be watchful of 12,380. If you see it trading below 12,380, go short for 12,300 and then below that you can see it crashing more. And yes, on the upside, there is a resistance here at 12,500 levels. Rather, I will say 12,460 levels itself you can go long or be a little generous, and rather I will recommend that you keep a little more cushion for 12,500. Yes, if you see it trading about 12,500, one can go long. See, this is at the top of the bands out there. Yes, there is a support. Also look at this, the hourly candle, similar size of candle you will get after this consolidation, and after this probably we may see further greener candles. It may break out on the upside. Be watchful here. This is just on the hourly candle. Directional movement bullish, stochastic looking upwards. MACD is trying to converge, crossover. RSI again looking upwards on the hourly charts. Look at the 2-hour charts, and on the 2-hour charts too, it is trying to rise from here. See, higher lows, and it is trying to give it a rise. Probably the next resistance zone, it's somewhere here at 12,460, 12,480 levels. Beyond that, we may see it rising. Be watchful of 12,510 levels, 520 levels, and beyond that, it is going to hit 12,600 and plus levels. And on the downside, 12,400 is the support now. Don't short anything till it is about 12,400. Directional movement is bullish, trying to converge. Stochastic looking upwards. MACD is on sell, trying to converge. RSI is overbought now. And if you look at the 3-hour charts, on the 3-hour charts, similarly, it is trying to give a breakout now. See, it is trying to rise. 12,510 levels you have to be watchful of. 12,400 you have to be watchful of. Beyond that, we may see sharper green candles, which may take it further rise. And this time, it can try to hit 12,650 levels, which is going to be the next resistance. Beyond that, 12,800 is there. Directional movement is bullish. Stochastic looking upwards. MACD trying to converge. RSI looking upwards here. And if you look at the 4-hour charts, on the 4-hour charts, see, on the 4-hour charts, it has created the steps. It has got the support, 12,400. Now it is trying to rise. Be watchful. It is still trying to trade in consolidation. Be watchful of 12,510 levels. Beyond 12,510, yes, you can go long for 12,640-50 zone, and then 12,800 can be also achieved. See, it is giving you a breakout after several consolidatory levels. Here is the reversal again, trying to rise from here. So be watchful of this. Directional movement bullish, stochastic looking upwards. MACD is in green. RSI is again overbought on the 4-hour charts. On the daily charts, look at this. On the daily charts, almost double top is done. And yes, this is also trading outside the Bollinger Bands. Also look at this, the previous candle, the bulls are not there to take the charge on it, not there to take the control on it, and hence it has formed the double top. It is also trading outside the Bollinger Bands. It may get pulled back again on the downside. We can see probably. I will be still cautious and I will not recommend you to take a long entry till it is below 12,510. Beyond that, yes, you can expect for 12,600 and plus levels. But till the time it is below 12,510, I will not recommend you to long entry. Yes, you can take a short entry below 12,400 and then one can expect it to drop till towards 12,250 levels. Be watchful of this. 12,510, 12,250 can be the probable trading zone. Directional movement not indicative of anything. Stochastic again overbought. MACD is wide divergent bullish. RSI is still divergent. Considering this, I will recommend you to go short only if you see it trading below 12,400. Rather, I will say 12,380 is the level below which you can go short. Then you can expect 12,300, 12,250 levels. Above 12,510, yes, you can go long. Rather, I will say 12,510 and 20, this is just 10 points, but you should watch there how it behaves over 12,500 and 12,520 levels. And beyond that, definitely you can expect it to hit 12,600. Then 12,600, 12,640, and then it will hit 12,800 levels if it continues to trade in a bullish zone. Be watchful, be careful, do not trade anything till it is below 12,500, 510 zone. And now let's have a look at Nasdaq Dow Jones. US 30 on the hourly charts, getting the support precisely from this 20 period moving average on the hourly charts is around 31,730, again trying to give it a rise. However, look at this, multiple candles getting rejected here at 31,950. I told you only long entries above 32,000 levels. I'll say the same thing again, that yes, go long only about 32,000, else it is trying to trade in between 31,700 to 32,000 level, 300 points. This is what it is trying to do. Directional movement is bullish on the hourly charts. Stochastic is bottom, trying to rise. MACD is trying to converge. RSI looking upwards on the hourly charts. Similarly, if you look at the 2 hour charts, look at the 2 hour charts, it has created the bottom, it has created lower. Now look closely at the 2 hour chart. See, 31,780 levels as the pivot, higher highs, lower lows. Now it may come back again till towards 31,780 levels. Below this, yes, you can go short again and expect it to drop. Also look at this, it is trying to give you lower highs, and if you connect this dot, it is giving you lower low. So be watchful between 31,880 and 31,780 levels. That is what is clear. Directional movement is bullish, stochastic is at bottom, MACD is wide divergent bearish, RSI is comfortable here. And if you look at the 3 hour charts, similarly on the 3 hour charts, look at this, it is trying to show you a reversal here, but at the same time it is giving you flat bottom on the 3 hour charts at around 31,730 levels. There is a support at 31,700. I have always told, any breakdown below 31,700, just go short and expect it to hit 31,600, 10,20 and then 31,500 levels on the upside. See, again look at this, there is a resistance at 31,940-50 zone. Be watchful, it can achieve this zone before looking forward to a drop there. Directional movement is bearish, stochastic is looking downwards, the MACD is wide divergent and bearish, RSI is near to top. Similarly, if you look at the 4-hour charts, yes, there is a support here at 31,600 zone, and then below that, yes, you can expect it to further drop till towards 31,500-400 level. Right now it is giving you lower high, a breakout is awaited, any move below this zone. If you see this, if you see it trading below 31,700, just go short here. And look at this, these three candles, it is almost trading in this channel, lower highs, lower low. There is a possibility to for it to achieve 31,900 levels. On the downside, 31,700 levels, should something be watchful of. Directional movement bullish, stochastic comfortable. MACD has crossed over for a sell here on the 4 hour charts, indicating probably we may see a drop from there. RSI comfortable. Coming to the daily charts, look at the daily charts. See, after this bullish candle, that was such a sharp candle that it is just trying to consolidate before it looks over to another bullish move. See, it is trading outside the Bollinger Bands, and hence it is getting the fairly strong resistance on the upside. Be watchful of 32,000 levels, only long entry above 32,000 level. For the day, it is giving you lower highs, higher lows. See, also now it is opened slightly above this previous candle. Probably we may see it coming back to 31,650, 31,600 then, but it may come back again on the upside. Be watchful, it can try to create a channel like this. So 31,600 to 950 is something you should be watchful of. Directional movement bearish, stochastic is overbought, MACD is wide divergent bullish, and RSI is comfortable. Considering this, I will recommend you to trade. Only long entry is above 32,010 levels. Beyond that, yes, you can stay long, and then you can expect a sharper rise till towards 32,200 and 32,350, 32,500. On the downside, if it trades below 31,700, till the time it rises till towards 31,900, yes, below 31,900, you can remain short, and one can expect that it can drop till towards 31,700 as the first target, 31,610 as the next target, and then 31,500 levels can also get achieved. In between 31,900 and 32,000, you have to trade with caution if it tries to achieve those levels. So trade accordingly, trade profitably, trade with a stop loss. Reach out to me for any of your trading or trading related queries. You can join my mentorship batch, the 15th batch is starting soon, and you can join my VIP signals group. Reach out to me for more details. My Telegram and email IDs are mentioned in the channel and video description. Thank you very much. Have a great profitable trading day. Thank you.